Hello everyone, welcome to PCBE classes. This is lecture number 9 on the basic electrical engineering. In today's lecture, we'll be discussing about the parallel connections of the resistors. Fine. So, before starting the parallel connection of the resistors, we should know what do you mean by the parallel. Parallel, something is parallel. These two lines are parallel. That means what? Its starting point and ending point are common. If I'll take two paths, this is a path, this is another path, fine. Or you can better understand in this way. I have the starting point at A, another starting point at B. Clear? I have to start my journey from A to B. I have two roads. Fine. I have two different roads. This is a road 1 and this is a road 2. I can move in either of the ways, in the road 1 as well as in the road 2. Clear? These two roads are said to be parallel to each other. Why? Because both the road have common starting point and have common ending point. So, two elements, two or more elements which are said to be parallel, what is the condition? Its starting point and the ending point should be common. So, we'll see here. I am talking about the parallel connection of the resistors. So, I have taken two resistors, R1, R2. Clear? Both should have common point, common starting point. Right? Common point. That means what? R1 will be connected to R2. This is the first point. And the second point is also connected. And now we can say that R1 and R2 are parallel to each other. Why? Why we will say? Because starting point of the R1 and starting point of the R2 both are same. And ending point of the R2 and ending point of the R1 both are same. So, these two will be said as parallel. Now, in order to understand the parallel connection of resistors, I have to put in a suitable circuit diagram. So, what I will do in order to understand it, I will give some supply. So, I have taken one voltage source and I am connecting this to the starting point of the resistors. And the ending point of the V, I am connected to the ending point of the resistors. Now see here, R1 and R2 are said to be parallel because both have starting and ending point common. Now a voltage is applied. If I am applying a voltage, naturally this voltage will supply certain current. Is it or not? Yes, it will pump some current. Let us take that current is I. Now, after coming to this point, the current decides to come back. Whatever the current will be pumped from the voltage source, the same current has to come back. Fine? So, in order to come back to this point, it has two different elements. Now, if two different elements, definitely the current will be divided. Let us take this current is I1 and the current which is flowing through the R2 is said to be the I2. Clear? Now, when this current enters through this resistor, definitely some polarity will be present. Plus, minus. I am taking this one as V1. Similarly, when I2 will enter, this will be positive, this will be negative. I am taking this voltage as V2. Is it clear? This I1 and I2 again comes back and meets at the common ending point and comes back as I1 and I2. Combination of the I1 and I2 is a I. So, this is a I coming back to the voltage source. This is the arrangement what we have done in the parallel combination. Clear? Now we'll analyze it. Let us analyze that one. During open circuit condition, I have said one thing. The voltage source positive polarity is connected to this point and its negative polarity is connected to this point. So what will be the voltage across it? The same voltage. So this V and this V1 will be same. Now, starting point of the R1 and ending point of the R2 both are same point. Same point. Thus, its voltage will be also equal to the V1. Definitely, it will be equal to the V. So, what is the condition first we are getting? What is the first condition we are getting? Voltage remains same for all resistance or resistors in parallel. That means what? V equals to V1 equals to V2. Clear? As both are parallel, so V1 and V2 will be equal, and as it is connected to the potential, that is a V, so it will be equal to the V. So this is the first point what we have to make a note of it. Fine. Next condition. See here, when the current enters to this node, now the current is divided. That means the current flowing in this R1 and current flowing in the R2 both are different. So what I'll say, second point, current is different and divided. How it is divided? As per KCL at node, at this node, I equals to I1 plus I2. Fine. This is the second condition we have got it. Clear? These are the two conditions which we have to take care while solving the problems for the parallel connections. Okay. So, applying KCL, as this voltage is same, so what will be its polarity here? What will be its potential? This potential will be also the same potential, that is V. And this is your common potential, so it is treated as ground, that is 0 volt. Fine. So we'll find out this I1. Apply KCL at this node. So what I'll get, I equals to I1 plus I2 as per the Ohm's law. What is it? V equals to IR. I equals to V by R. So as per this one, what else can I say? This entire circuit, I can consider entire circuit, can I consider as a single R, and I can write down this one as R equivalent. I can write it. So what I'll do, I'll write down this one as, if I'll replace it, V by R equivalent. Fine. Equals to I1. What is the current flowing I1? Voltage. What is the voltage? V divided by R1. So it is V by R1. Similarly, this will be, what is the potential? V. V1 equals to V2 equals to V. So it will be V by R2. So what I am getting, 1 by R equivalent equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. This implies R equivalent equals to R equivalent equals to R1 multiplied with R2 divided by R1 plus R2. This is what we say the third condition for this parallel network. If it is a parallel network, parallel combination of the resistance, we have to take this formula as R1 into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Clear? These are the three conditions which you have to take care while solving the problems on the parallel connection of the resistors. Fine? Now, moving to the next one. Here you can see that the current comes here and the current is divided. I1, I2. So, we have to find out what is the value of this I1 and I2 in terms of I. In terms of I. Let's solve for that one. So, we know that I equals to I1 plus I2. So, we will find out the I1. What is I1? V by R1. Equation number 1. What is I2? V by R2. Equation number 2. Clear? So, from 1 and 2. Can I write down V equals to I1 into R1, that is equals to I2 into R2, right? Which implies I1 by I2, I1 by I2 equals to R2 by R1. Can I write? Yes. So, this is the equation number 3. Clear? So, from equation 3, what I'll write down? I1 equals to I2 into R2 by R1, whereas I2 is equals to I1 into R1 by R2. Let us take this one as the equation number 4 and this as equation number 5. And let us take this equation number as 6. Substitute 4 or 5 in 6. So, what I will get? I equals to I1 plus I2, that is equals to I1 plus I1 into R1 by R2. So, I can be written as I1 multiplied with R2 plus R1 divided by R2, which implies I1 will be equals to I multiplied with R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Equation number 7. If I will substitute four in 6, fine, I will get as I2 will be equals to I multiplied with R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Fine. So two formulas we have got it. I'll write down this one again. I1 equals to I into R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Fine. We have got the I1 and I2 values in terms of the total current which is supplied. That is the I. Now let us formulate in a proper way. If I'll take I1, how I'm getting I1? I is the total current supplied. So I'll write down this one as total current supplied multiplied with, here it is I1, but we have taken R2. I1 I'm finding out, but I'm talking about the R2. What is that one? Opposite resistance. Fine. So what I'll say, this one, opposite resistance divided by sum of resistances or resistors in parallel. You can see here. I2. So opposite resistance will be R1. Opposite parallel resistance. For I2, opposite parallel resistance will be R1. The total current multiplied with the R1 divided by sum of the resistance in parallel. How many resistors are there? Two. Both are parallel. So R1 plus R2. Fine. This form, what we have got it, is stated as current divider rule. Current divider rule. Fine. Make a note of it. Let's see problem related to the parallel connection of the resistors. Fine. This is a circuit arrangement given here. This is a question. A 3 ohm resistor and the 6 ohm resistor are connected to form a particular circuit. Right? And the first question, it is saying that find out the R equivalent across AB. The meaning is observing from this side, from AB terminals, you have to find out the R equivalent. Fine. Second bit, it is saying that if a 18 volt source, if a 18 volt source is connected across A and B, clear? Then find out the current in 3 ohm and current in 6 ohm. That is the second bit. Clear? Third bit, it is saying that find the total current supplied if, that is the 18 volt source is connected. If 18 volt source is connected, what is the total current it is supplying to the entire circuit? So let us solve this one. The first one, we'll find out the R equivalent. R equivalent. Now, observing from this side means what? Observing from AB side means we are assuming that the current is flowing from this side. We are assuming. Then the current is divided. Now we'll see that these two currents are meeting at the ending point. Here, 3 ohm and 6 ohm are having the common starting point and the ending point. That means 3 and 6 are parallel to each other. Parallel to each other. So, what is the R equivalent in case of the parallel? R1, R2 divided by R1 plus R2. What is the R equivalent then? What is the R equivalent? R1 is 3 multiplied with 6 divided by 3 plus 6. So it is 18 by 9. So R equivalent equals to 2 ohms. This is my first answer. Fine. If this is the case, R equivalent, the same circuit can be redrawn as, this is a terminal A, this is a terminal B, the entire thing we have to reduce to R equivalent. What is R equivalent? We have got 2 ohm. So this is R equivalent equals to 2 ohm, or can I write down here 2 ohm. Clear? This is the first bit. Fine. Moving to the second one. What is the second one it is saying? Second one is saying that if an 18 volt source is connected across AB, so I'll connect a 18 volt source here. I'll connect a 18 volt source. The first part is over. Fine. First part is over. So I'm erasing the first question. 18 volt is connected. 18 volt is connected. Here this is the 18 volt source. What I'm connecting here? 18 volt. What will be the current flowing in the 3 ohm? What will be the current flowing in the 3 ohm? Let us take this one as the I 3 ohm, and let us take this current is I 6 ohm. So what will be my current? What will be my current? We have derived the current divider rule. While deriving, I have said that this 18 volt is connected across it. So this terminal voltage will be 18 volt again. So what is the voltage for the 3 ohm? 18 volt. For the 6 ohm? 18 volt. So what is the current here? I'll write down. For the second one, I'm saying it. So current in 3 ohm will be equals to terminal voltage divided by R. What is that? V. What is that? 18 divided by 3. How much? 6 ampere. Fine. Similarly, I 6 ohm is equals to V by R. What is the terminal voltage for this one? As these two are parallel, so its terminal voltage or the voltage across it will be same as per the first condition of the parallel connection. So it is 18 divided by 6, that is 3 ampere. So if I'll assume that this current is I and applying KCL at, let us take this node is A, because if this is the point A and this node will be also A, so at point A, what I'll get? I is equals to I 3 ohm plus I 6 ohm. What is the answer we have got? 6 plus 3 equals to 9 ampere. This is the third bit. This third bit can be done in a different way. What is the R equivalent of this? 2 ohm. Fine. Across AB, what I have connected? What is the voltage? 18 volt. So what will be my current? V equals to IR. So V equals to IR. I equals to V by R. What is the V? 18. What is the R equivalent? 2. So I equals to 9 ampere. Fine. In this way, we can solve the problem of the parallel connections of the resistors. You can make a note of it. Let's see another variety of problem. Fine. This is circuit given. Total supply voltage is 18 volt. R 3 ohm, 6 ohm. Three resistors are there. You can observe from the problem also that all the three are starting point and the ending point are same. So all the three are in parallel. So you have to find out this R value. What should be the resistance value if the total current supplied is 20 ampere? What it is given? If the total current it is supplying is 20 ampere, then what is the resistance value? Fine, this is the first bit. Second bit, find current in R ohm. You have to find out the current in the R ohm. So let's find out that. Now, R3, 3 ohm, 6 ohm are in parallel. If it is parallel, the supply voltage will be same for all. So, voltage across 3 ohm will be equals to voltage across 6 ohm, will be equals to voltage across R ohm, will be equals to 18 volt. Clear? So, what I'll take, if I'll find out the current here, this current will be I3 ohm, this current will be I6 ohm, and this is IR ohm. So, I3 ohm will be equals to, what is the voltage? V3 ohm divided by 3. What is that? 18 by 3, so it is 6 ampere. Similarly, I6 ohm will be V6 ohm divided by, what is the resistance value? 6. So it is 18 by 6. How much? 3 ampere. Clear? Now, applying KCL at this point. Let us take this point as A. Applying KCL at A. What I'll get? 20 ampere is equals to IR ohm plus I3 ohm plus I6 ohm. So IR ohm will be equals to 20 minus I3 ohm plus I6 ohm. Can I write down? Yes. I3 ohm, what is the current? 6. And for this one, 3. So IR ohm will be equals to how much? 20 minus, what is this one? I3. 6 plus 3. 6 plus 3, that is 9. 20 minus 9 IR ohm will be equals to 20 minus 9, that is 11 ampere. So we got the second part of the question. What is the first part? You have to find out this R. Clear? What should be the value of R? As we know IR ohm, as we know the voltage across VR ohm is 18 volt. So as per Ohm's law, what I'll write down? VR ohm will be equals to IR ohm multiply with R. So R will be equals to VR ohm divided by IR ohm. What is the VR ohm? 18 by 11 is the answer for the first one. Clear? This is about the parallel combination problems. More problems you will be solving in the practice session. Thank you.